I play a character called Monroe, who in the scheme of the high rise is at the very, very top, which means he is the one of the privileged in the very upper echelons of society, sort of financially and societally? Terrible. It's not a good word. I'm a student of Mr. Tom Hiddleston, Mr. Robert Lang, and we have a rivalry that spins out of control, shall we say. I'll leave it at that. You have to see the movie to find out how. Tom nails it in this one, to be honest. Tom is also just a wonderful guy, which I think is why he's very special to work with. He's just a magic actor. He's just one of those people who's incredibly intelligent and brings a depth to everything that he does. And it was a privilege to work with him. I've known Tom for a while. We've known each other for about 5 years or so. And we've been wanting to work together for so long. So it was amazing that we finally got to. He's a great guy. He's a fantastic actor, yeah. I mean, Ben is fantastic at dystopian universes. Ben is probably the best director right now working who is able to create a universe that is genuinely terrifying and I think he was able to capture the sense of foreboding that is in the novel. And Amy, his wife, very talented couple that they are, have created a movie that is just bubbling with evil and savagery, but it's hidden by this fantastic sheen of civilization, which very quickly crumbles in a great way, in a very amusing way.
The location is a huge character in the film. Can you talk about your experience of that?
We actually shot it, movie magic, we shot it in Belfast in a disused sports centre that they turned into this fantastic recreation of a 1970s high-rise. And the idea of the location is that it's sort of a classically brutalist, you know, it's that classic 1970s concrete, sort of faceless, and it really adds to the sense of dehumanization, which is eventually what triggers this sort of descent into savagery amongst the characters. And so it's a very important part of the movie. And it also looks beautiful. It looks fantastic aesthetically as well. I mean, I live in Los Angeles these days, and so coming back to London for me is always an absolute pleasure because it's my hometown and I love it. And I miss it a lot. So to bring this film to the London Film Festival means everything to me. You know, I'm very, very proud of it. I brought my brother with me tonight, so it's nice to sort of be able to bring my family to it, to be honest. So for me, it's a personal thing, but also it's the London Film Festival. It's one of the most important film festivals in the world, so very exciting.